Hello, my name is Nicolaus Copernicus, and I changed the world. Imagine that you lived at a time long ago, when there were no telescopes, satellites, spacecraft, or even airplanes. A time when most people rarely ventured very far from the place they were born. Looking out to the horizon, it would be easy to think that the world only extended as far as you could see. The whole universe consisted of the earth under your feet and the sky over your head. You would see the sun, moon, and stars swirling around the earth like bees around a hive. The man was dominant over the plants and animals of the world and was told by God that this was their kingdom. That man was chosen and special in this world. The man was the center and focus of everything. I was born at a time when everyone, including myself, believed that the universe consisted of God, man, and the earth, which was at the center of the universe. Even the brightest minds of my generation thought that man was most important, and that the rest of the universe was rotating around him. All of you watching this video don't know how powerful and important we thought we were, because you take for granted how vast the universe is. Your generation is taught that we must work hard to become someone great. However, in my time, we all were special just because we were human beings. No one, not even myself, was ready for what I was about to reveal to the world. Many of you think that Galileo is the one who discovered the fact that the Earth rotates around the sun. But I'll tell you a secret. It was me. Unlike Galileo, I had no telescope. I only needed the intellect God gave me to understand that I'm not the center of the universe, or even the center of our beloved Earth. The old view of the universe with Earth at the center didn't make sense. It just didn't work. That model didn't fit the patterns and movement of the stars and planets in the sky. It didn't explain the seasons and the cycles of the sun. I used mathematics and years of hard work to develop a new conception of the universe. Sometimes things are so simple and easy to understand, but we lack the courage to look at them straight in the face and discover their true nature. When people realized that we had to rely on ourselves in order to move forward, and that we had no one above looking in on us or trying to help us judge us, we started to unlock the potential in our minds. The modern wonders you see around you, including the computer you're watching this on, were achieved because we don't need any help from any god or deity. We only need to believe in ourselves. This idea was threatening to those in power at the time. Many of you think that the church was behind my death, but that was not the truth. The truth is that I was condemned by everyone I know, and I was called a heretic by my closest friends. In your time, there are many revolutionary ideas, but even today, your people call the scientists who theorize them lunatics. Part of me wishes that I wish we were that important as we thought. I wish we were the center of everything. I wish this idea hadn't threatened those in power so much, leading some followers of my ideas to even be killed. But the reality is always harder to accept. So you can say, I died twice. The first was when I realized that everyone, including the closest ones to me, would not accept the facts that I discovered. To someone like me who greatly values truth, this was just like death. My second death was my physical death. Ironically, I died of a stroke which happens in the brain, and it's my brain that gave me the insight I needed for my discoveries. Perhaps I worked my brain too hard. But before I died, I was as sure as I could be of anything that no matter how much you don't want to see or understand the truth, it will always prevail. My ideas weren't perfect. Science wouldn't be science if our understanding of things wasn't always changing and evolving. Now you know that even the sun isn't the center of the universe like I thought, but is rather part of a giant rotating spiral galaxy of billions of stars. And that galaxy is one of many billions of others, all speeding and spinning through the vastness of space. How many other Earths are out there? How many other beings like you and me are staring out into the night sky and wondering what else is out there to be discovered? Our galaxy is an endless ocean of other galaxies, and we're just like tiny ants, trying to understand our place in the universe.